Hey everyone, what's up? Welcome to a new playthrough, Grand Theft Auto Vice City. I'm really excited to play this. As you know, I'm a huge GTA fan. I love these games. So we're just gonna hop straight into it. New game, let's do it.
Tommy Vercetti? Shit. Didn't think they'd ever let him out.
He kept his head down, helps people forget.
People will remember soon enough. When they see him walking down the streets of their neighborhoods, it will be bad for business.
Well? What are we gonna do, Sonny?
We treat him like an old friend and keep him busy out of town, okay? We've been talking about expanding down south, right? Vice City is 24 karat gold these days. The Colombians, the Mexicans, hell, even those Cuban refugees are cutting themselves a piece of some nice action.
But it's all drugs, Sonny. None of the families will touch that shit.
Times are changing. The families can't keep their backs turned while our enemies reap the rewards. So, we send someone down to do the dirty work for us and cut ourselves a nice, quiet slice, okay? Who's our contact down there?
Kem Rosenberg, schmuck of a lawyer. How's he gonna hold Vercetti's leash?
We don't need him to. We just set him loose in Vice City. We give him a little cash to get started, okay? Give it a few months. Then we go down. Pay him a little visit, right? See how he's doing.
To be honest, I never actually noticed that dead guy hanging there in the back. Never noticed that before.
Hey, hey, guys, it's Ken Rosenberg here.
Ken?
Hey, hey, great, hey. Well, I'm gonna drive you guys to the meet, okay? Now, I've talked to the suppliers, and they are very keen to start a business relationship. So, if all goes well, we should be doing very nicely for ourselves, which is, you know, good. Okay, so, they're brothers, okay? One operates the business, and the other one does the flying. Okay, that's them in the chopper. All right, here's the deal.
Lots.
They want a straight exchange on open ground. All right? Okay, stay tight, let's go.
And Vance as well.
Got it?
100% pure grade A Colombian, my friend.
Let me see it.
The greens?
10s and 20s. Used.
I think we have a deal, my friend.
Oh, shit! Come on, get out of here! Ah!
I poked my head out of the gutter for one freaking second and fate shovels shit in my face. Go get some sleep. What are you gonna do?
I'll drop by your office tomorrow and we can start sorting this mess out.
Alright, let's do this. So, that was Victor Vance from, Vice City Stories, if you didn't know. The one giving the drugs, handing them over, but yeah, let's do this. I love that cutscene though, it's awesome. Anyway.
We interrupt your programming with a message from the State Department. All bridges and some roads in the Vice City metropolitan area have been closed because of a severe weather warning. Meteorologists are tracking Hurricane Hermione, which has devastated 5 Caribbean islands and is heading for Vice City. More updates soon.
So there's a hurricane coming, but that's okay. Let's just go in here. Save your progress by collecting the cassette tape pickup. Walk into the marker, okay. Let's go. Old friend. What's up, Sonny?
Hello, Sonny.
Tommy! Tommy, it's been too long. I know. You're just overwhelmed with emotion. 15 years.
Seems like only yesterday.
I guess that's a perspective thing.
Hey, doing time for the family is no piece of cake, but the family looks after its own, okay? So how'd the deal go down? You sitting on some white gold?
Look, Sonny, we were set up. It's an ambush. Harry and Lee are dead.
You better be kidding me, Tommy! Tell me you still got the money!
No, Sonny. I don't have the money.
That was my money, Tommy! My money! You better not be screwing me, Tommy, because you know I'm not a man to be screwed with!
Wait, Sonny.
You have my personal assurance that I'm gonna get you your money back, and the drugs, and I'm gonna mail you the dicks of those responsible.
Hey, I already know that. You're not a fool, Tommy, but I warn you, neither am I. If it was anybody else, you'd be dead already. But because it's you, because we got history, I'm gonna let you handle this.
Look, Sonny, you got my word.
I'll be in touch.
Hey, look at Claude in the back on that picture. So Tommy's in a bit of trouble, but it's okay. It's gonna be fine. I'm gonna save it in slot 3. So let's go see Ken Rosenberg. Let's see how he's doing.
Go get some sleep, he says. I have been sitting in this chair all night with the lights off, drinking coffee. This is a disaster. We are so screwed, man. These gorillas, listen to me, are gonna come down here and rip my head off. It's ridiculous. I did not go to law school for this. Okay, now what the hell are we gonna do?
Shut up, sit down, relax.
Definitely
I'll tell you what we're gonna do. You're gonna find out who took our cocaine, and then I'm gonna kill them.
That's a good idea. That's a great idea. Let me think. Oh, there's this retired colonel, Colonel Juan Garcia Cortez. He's the one that helped me set up this deal well away from Vice City's established thugs, okay? Now listen, he's having his party out in the bay on his expensive yacht, and all of Vice City's big players are gonna be there, okay? I have an invite. Of course I have an invite. But there's no way that I'm going out there sticking my head out the door. No way,
not gonna happen. Shut up. I'll go myself.
Oh, whoa. Hey, I like 1978 too, but you know, this isn't gonna be a beer and strippers do. I mean, no offense, but I think that you might turn heads on the runway for the wrong reasons.
What's wrong with the way I'm dressed?
Okay, look, here, stop by Raphael's. Tell him I sent you. He'll make you look respectable. Okay, go, come on.
What does that guy think he is? Now I gotta dress like a chump as well as hang out with him? I like this shirt.
Okay. Let's head over to the clothing store. I've arrived. Looking good in the suit. Let's do this.
Nice bike. No, my bike.
Okay, let's go. There's num 9 and num 6 to shift the weight. Yep, I already knew that one. Yeah, we're gonna go meet Juan Garcia Cortez. That's his name, right?
On the toll road of life, you have to pay to prove you can. Live the emotion.
Okay, made it. Pier 2.
Buenas noches.
Hey, there he is.
I understand you are here on the behalf of Mr. Rosa. I hope any recent problems have not affected his health or mental well-being, Mr.
Rossetti. He's just got a touch of agoraphobia.
Excellent. And you?
I just want my merchandise.
Ah, it's an unfortunate set of circumstances for all involved. Of course, I have initiated my own lines of inquiry, but such a delicate matter will take time. Perhaps we'll talk later. Meanwhile, let me introduce you to my daughter. Miss Davis! Cara mia, could you look after our guest while I attend to my necessary obligations?
Of course, Daddy.
Please, excuse me.
Mercedes?
You try living with her. Anyway, let me point out some of our more distinguished guests. That's our Congressman Alex Shrubb with Rising Silicone Star. candy sucks.
And have you met my lovely wife, Laura? No? Well, unfortunately, she's in Alabama. This is candy.
And over there, we have City Mamba's star titan, BJ. Always the charmer.
I blocked down on him, and then I put him in a wheelchair.
That is good. Well, now I'm looking at some prime.
And that poolside amphibian is Jez Torrent, lead singer with Love Fist.
Yeah, can I tell you? Do you know how they play ping pong in Thailand? Let me tell you. It does not involve a paddle, if you know what I mean.
Impotent. And the chatty trio, that sleeping sweat gland is Papa's right-hand gimp, Gonzalez. And the other two are Pastor Richards and pseudo-intellectual film director Steve Scott.
Fishing throws a passion with the nympho invaders when the giant shark comes in and just bites their dicks off. Now, you never saw anything like that before.
Colonel, your party's as ever a triumph. I can only apologize.
Oh, then another amigo. How do we find you?
Our business is very trying. Barbarians at the gate. A time for rewarding one's friends and liquidating one's enemies, amigo.
Who's the loudmouth?
Ricardo Diaz. He's Mr. Cope.
Mercedes!
Oh, I was just taking my friend back into town. Another time, Ricardo.
Ricardo, let's go.
Let's get out of here. Actually, take me to the pole position. Drinks.
I don't like Diaz, man. I never liked him. Anyway, take the colonel's daughter to the pole position club, which is...
Would you be working for my father?
Maybe.
Do you mind me resting my hand in your lap?
Maybe.
It's so difficult having a rich and powerful father. Vamos.
A river. We need a river.
All right, well, pretty much arrived at the pole position, so let's drop her off.
Fashion crime, drugs.
See you around, handsome.
Absolutely. Of course it is.
I'm sure you will.
But they were happy. See you later, Mercedes. You so far, I say I might do one more mission and probably end it for today. It's probably a good spot to end it soon, anyway.
Great lake of sand and a massive speaking dog. It was.
All right, here we go. Back alley brawl.
Ah, well, I hope you're having a good time because I'm going out of my mind with worry here. What did you find out?
That there are more criminals in this town than in prison. We need a lead from the streets.
Okay, let me think. Ah, I got it. Okay, there's this limey, some music industry slimeball. Goes by the name of Kent Paul. Anyway, he's got his nose so far up most of Vice City's ass that if anybody knows the whereabouts of 20 keys of coke, it's this guy, all right? He's always at the Malibu.
I'll go pay him a visit.
Take it easy now.
Don't worry, Ken. It's gonna be all right, man. So, go to the Malibu Club and find Kent Paul. That's that, British guy. Sorry about that. Let's go.
Where'd you pop up from? I've been looking for you for ages, mate. You
know what I am? Looking for some English guy.
Kent Paul.
Kent Paul, mate.
Yeah, I'm the governor, Andy. I'll sort things out. You know what I mean? I'll treat you. Whatever you want, I'll get you, girl. Don't you worry about a thing, mate.
Get lost, honey.
Wait.
You Kent Paul? I'm a friend of Rosenberg's.
Rosenberg. Oh, that bonkers ambulance chase. That guy could defend an innocent man all the way to death row. Get another drink, bruv.
Everybody's a comedian. Listen to me. I'm missing 20 keys and a lot of cash.
Drugs, mate? It's a mugs game.
What do you know about it?
Oi, well, what I was coming to was, there's some chef come trumpet shifter who deals at kitchen of Hotel and Ocean Drive. He's been looking real pleased with himself lately. You could go and check him out.
I will. And I'll be seeing you around.
Yeah, that's right. Go and walk away, you mug. I knock you spark out. Give me a drink. And where's that slut?
That cousin always makes me laugh. It's so funny. His accent is just so good. I mean, anyone else, I know, like, that's what it actually sounds like. Socialist, jiggery, pokery, just make it so nanny. Funny, America what he's saying. Hope. Not songs that are supposed to send food to the poor. Anyway, songs let's will go meet up with this dude and, you know, talk to him.
Hey, what you looking at? You better start talking. Hey, make me, you prick.
Oh my gosh. Sorry if you can hear my mouse, it's a bit loud, but, you know. Now we've got a cell phone. You can now receive phone calls.
Oh, way to go, tough guy. Beat him to a pulp. That should make him real chatty.
You want some too?
Hey, chill. I want what you want, brother.
Oh, yeah? And what's that?
Your green and my dead brother's white lady. Unfortunately, you just silenced our lead.
Accidents happen. Get lost.
Hey, whoa. No need to go all long range on my ass. The way I see it, we two hombres in a strange town. We need to watch each other's back.
My back's just fine, brother.
You sure about that? Here, take this. Follow me.
His eyes did that thing again, where they went big.
This way!
Alright, well, I'm not gonna worry about taking them out because they just have, like, melee weapons. So I just, follow Lance to his car, which is right here. We've left Lance behind, go and get him.
No, one thing
right
you gotta realize about this town, you gotta pack some heat. Local gun shops, a couple of blocks away.
Alright, let's get ammunition and check it out. I don't think we'll be buying a gun. I think this is just telling you. Ammunition, this is where you can buy guns.
They call me Wet Fart.
They call me the Bat because my voice didn't break until I was 19.
So, Mr. Shrub, I take it you don't believe in regulation.
Driving,
I believe
right
in giving people a chance, not tying them down with lots
so good
of needless regulations. The fact is, business is.
Stand in the pink marker, yeah, I don't know that already. You can select weapons by pressing left or right on the directional button.
Come on, I'm late for tenant.
Have enough cash, you can buy weapons, you can exit the shop. Yeah, I already know this stuff, but, you know. I've played this game quite a bit. I've done a lot of playthroughs on this game. So let's just go back to the hotel, we don't need to really buy anything right now.
Not true. Only 23 people have died, and several of them probably deserved it.
So, with people being set such a bad example by big business, how are they supposed to respect it?
To act safely in society?
And how are they policed by a demoralized and underfunded police force?
Well, I'm afraid that's apparently quite a difficult question, but my solution is easy. I'm gonna talk for a long time about a subject not in any way related, and pretty soon people will forget all about it. I'll remind people that I great haircut, and then under my stewardship, Vice City.
I'm gonna go see what I can dig up. I'll be watching you, Tommy.
See you, Lance. I don't even think Tommy knows his name yet, right? No, he doesn't yet. That's funny. I'm gonna end the episode right here. I hope you all enjoyed. I am really excited to be getting back into some GTA games. I know I had a lot of Crash Bandicoot and some Rayman, some Tekken recently as well.
Hey, Leo, I think we got a buyer for Diaz's merchandise. Gotta give him a ring, man. Set up the deal, you know?
Where are you now?
You okay, Leo? You sound kinda different.
Just tell me where you are.
Who the hell is this? Put Leo on, man.
Leo's gone away for a while. He left me in charge.
Screw you, man.
Anyway, thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And I will see you in episode 2 coming soon.